Hello friends, today we are going to learn or discuss a new topic, that is work and energy. This is the second lesson from 9th standard science. See, let's start with work. What is work? Work is nothing but some activities. Consider that one. That activities may be divided into two parts. First, a physical activity. Second is mental activity. Some are there, studying, then reading, then watching TV. So these are the three activities now we are considering. So within this one, definitely you are using your mental power. That means energy is vested to read, to write, to watch the TV. Definitely we are using our energy. But within this one, work is there, but that work is mental work. Or suppose you are speaking. To speak, this is also an activity. Within that one, our mental power is we are using, and energy is also used up by our body. But now we are discussing physical activity. That means what? Running activity. Then walking activity. Or you are cycling. Here also we are using energy. So these all are considered as a physical activity. Now what is a basic change? Suppose at one place you are reading, that is the X place is there. From this X place you have started to read, and after ending that activity again you are at the X place. But see here, when you start to run, that location is X, and when you complete the activity, then you reach at point Y. In walking also, you are starting your walking from location X, and at the end of this activity, you are reaching at location Y. So what is there? Here we having displacement. Yes, displacement. But here we do not get no displacement. No displacement. So this is the difference in between these physical activities and the mental activities. Then both the activities are considered as a work. I am working, I am teaching here. Teaching is also activity. But within teaching, I have started my teaching here only. And towards the end of teaching, I will be here. That means no displacement. So this is called as mental activity. And physical activity, within that one we are getting the displacement, change in the previous position or change in the position of a object. Definitely there is a distance or difference in between the initial position and the final position, so we are getting the displacement. So which work is called as work? Generally in our day-to-day life, both activities are called as work. But in physics, see, all kind of work is not considered as a work, or all kind of activities are not considered as a work. So which activity? See here, work has special meaning in physics. And what is the special meaning? See, work is said to be done. Work done ho gaya, hum kab kar sakte hai? One condition is there. When a force applied on an object. One object is there. See, what kind of object is there? See, this is one object. Object, and if you are applying force, a force applied on it, you are applying force from this direction, you are pushing that object, and if that causes displacement of the object, definitely this is a force F, and here because of the applied force there is a displacement, then only it is said that work is done. That means work is said to be done when a force applied on an object causes its displacement. If displacement is not there, see, I am pushing this board backward. Have I applied force here or not? Definitely I have applied force, but because of my force, there is no displacement of that board. So definitely here in physics, it is not a work done. What is this? It is a pin. If I will push the pen, if I will apply the force on this pen, then definitely pen is moving or there is a displacement, change the position. Huh. In physics, it is a work done. So, new concept we are dealing with. So, what is meant by work? In physics, work is said to be done when a force applied on an object causes the displacement of an object, then only it is work. So, work is directly proportional to force. How? More the force, more the displacement we are getting, or more the work done we are getting. That means if you want to run, from one location which is here only, and you want to run 1 kilometer. So, little force you need, but if the same person want to cover a 10 kilometer distance, he has to apply more force. So, that means what? If you are going to apply more force, then definitely you are doing more work done. Or suppose you want to lift a brick. To lift a one brick, to pick up the one brick, you need little force. But if there are 4 to 5 bricks are there, and if you want to lift it up, if you want to pick it up, then definitely more force you need. To take a small baby from the ground, need the less force. But suppose you are in the 9th standard, you want to hold you, or you want to hold some person who is huge one, to pick that person up, to lift that person up, you need more force. So more the force, more is work done. Then what is about the displacement? Here is also, displacement is directly proportional to work, or work is directly proportional to displacement. If more work you need, that means more displacement is there. Suppose you want to carry a bag. If 1 kilometer you have carried a bag and second person carried that 3 kilometer, that means whose displacement is more? You have displaced that bag from that shop to 1 kilometer only. But the second person has carried or has displaced that bag from that location, that shop, to 3 kilometer. That means in the second example, second person displaces that object for a longer distance, so definitely his work done is more. So what is the relation here? Work is directly proportional to force, and work is directly proportional to displacement. So what is the result of that? Yes, it is, work is nothing but the product of force and displacement. So how we should present this one? See how work is equal to force into displacement. This final equation we are getting, but when we are getting this equation, see here, if object is there and force is in this direction getting, and displacement is also in the same direction, then we are going to use this formula, W is equal to F into S, that is work done is equal to force into displacement. When force and displacement are parallel to each other, some other cases are there, that also we are going to discuss. Let's discuss once again. If object is displaced in this direction because of applied force S, that means all force and displacement of an object is in the same direction, that means they are parallel to each other, then what is the formula? Work done is equal to, or work is equal to, force into displacement. But one problem is that, see here, that girl is pulling that toy car towards her. But see, this is the force applied because the girl is pulling that toy car towards this direction. But here we having displacement along the road, getting? So what is here? That means here there is an angle. Suppose that angle is theta angle made by that. Then can we use this formula? No. This formula can be used only in this case when displacement and force in the same direction. But now this that is the force applied on the object towards upward, and displacement of that object is towards or parallel to ground or horizontal one. So here, where you are applying force, there object is not moving, somewhere else object is moving. So which formula we have to derive? See here, I am explaining this one. This is a toy car. Consider this part is P, location P. Then object is moving straight. That means here Q. But PR, towards R, force is there. Though you are giving the force towards R, a little force, that is F1, exists on that car which made that car to move towards that girl. That is F1 we are considering. So what is F? F is an exact force applied. That is the force applied in this direction, or direction of force applied. Then what is F1? F1 means what? Component of force. That means now force is acting on that car or made that car to move towards that girl. That is, this is direction. PQ is the direction of component of force, and PR is the direction exactly force applied. So see, you will get this information in, that is, geometry towards the last lesson. That is trigonometry, one lesson is there. Within that lesson, you will get that information. In short, I am explaining. See, what is cos theta? See, this theta is the angle. When we consider this one as a 90 degree, when we consider this triangle as a 90 degree triangle, and this both angles are acute angles, out of this angle P is considered as a theta, then what is here? PR is a hypotenuse for this. Then PQ is an adjacent side to theta, and PQ is a, or QR is a opposite side to theta. So what is cos theta? Cos theta is adjacent side of theta. What is this? Adjacent side of theta divided by hypotenuse. So see, which is adjacent side to theta? Theta, this one is adjacent side to PQ. Okay, and PR, PR means hypotenuse, hypotenuse PR. But see here, what is PR? PR is nothing but F. Cos theta is equal to F divided by F1. F1 is a component of force which makes move towards that girl, to that toy car. So here, see, when we do the cross multiplication of this one, we are getting F is equal to what? Here, we are getting F is equal to F1 into cos theta. So that is equation number 1. And now we are going to use this formula. F is equal, work done is equal to F into S. That is equal to F1 cos theta into S. This is the formula we are going to use. Or finally we can write like this one. F1 S into cos theta. F1 S into cos theta. Then see, that means this cos theta plays very important role within that one. At which degree you are applying the force to the horizontal. Getting? Suppose this force you are applying is, that degree is 90 degree or 0. First we are considering 0 degree. Then we are considering 90 degree. And lastly we are going to consider 180 degree. So see, what is my conclusion? First, 0 degree. 0 degree means what? See here, this is the force applied. And displacement is along the same direction. That means both lines are overlapping. Overlapping lines means what? 0 degree. And when 0 degree is there, cos of theta is 1. Then here, Fs into 1, that is, work done is equal to only Fs, but that is positive. Now, when 90 degree, that is the first condition. See, I am explaining the condition here. First, 0 degree, that means both the lines are overlapping. Like this one. That means you are pushing the trolley. Trolley is also, you are pushing the trolley towards forward, and trolley is also moving towards the same direction. Now the second 90 degree, that means what? The object is on the ground. See, object is on the ground, and that object is pulled downward by the gravitational force of gravity. So what is that? Here object is moving, दो ऑब्जेक्ट इज, सपोज यू आर होल्डिंग वन बैग एंड वॉकिंग, दैट मीन्स मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट बैग इज टूवर्ड्स दिस डायरेक्शन. एट द सेम टाइम ग्रेविटेशन फोर्स इज ऑल्सो ऑन दैट ऑब्जेक्ट टूवर्ड्स डाउनवर्ड. सो हियर वी हैविंग 90 degree, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इट लेटर अगेन. और सपोज अ पेन इज देयर एंड यू आर अप्लाइंग फोर्स टूवर्ड्स दिस डायरेक्शन, गेटिंग, सो पेन विल नॉट मूव. सो लाइक दिस वन 90 degree वी आर कंसिडरिंग हियर. सो cos of 90 is 0, then W is also 0. Then the third example, see, suppose a car is moving towards this direction, and you are applying force towards opposite direction, though car is moving, because car is having the force. Or have you seen any movie, the bullfighting? The person is holding the horns of that bull and pushing that bull backward. But because of force applied by that bull, the person is also moving towards the same direction. Though he is applying force towards forward, the bull is coming opposite to that force. So in this way, we having 90 degree. See, this one is a force, this one is a displacement, and you are applying force towards this direction. And so it is 180 degree. So 180 degree, here cos theta is -1. Cos theta is -1, and so work done is -Fs. That is force into displacement. So what is conclusion? See here, when this theta is 0 degree, when 0 degree, we are getting answer positive. That means positive work done is there. When theta is 180 degree, we are getting answer negative. So here negative work done is there. And when this theta is 90 degree, then totally work done is 0. So how many kind of work done are there? There are 3 kinds of work done. Number 1, positive work done, negative work done, and 0 work done. That we are going to discuss in detail.